Well, about an hour ago, this little J.A.P engine was delivered. I've just got to the point of getting a spark. I've put the wheels back on the trolley, the handles back on. As you can see, we've got two tanks, petrol and oil. This is a dry sump engine. And it runs a total loss system. There's no return. So, what you do, you have that open a little bit. And there's a pump in there. Well, the way it works, the breather in there is timed to the cam. So it sucks a bit of fuel through the crankshaft, oil through the crankshaft rather. Blasts it through all the bearings, quite clever. So you're supposed to be able to see it through that gauge. I think it was working. I saw it sucking some through when I turned it over earlier, so hopefully it'll be okay. But what I'll do, I'll put a bit of oil in the fuel or down the bore or something, and then when I start it up, I can just glance at that. If it's not coming through, then I'll stop it straight away. Should have a spark now. You can see that, but there is one there. Nice big silencer. Very little wear in any of the bearings. Very slight lift, but nothing major. Got a second flywheel on this side and a pulley. No wear in that side. The engine actually has four flywheels. You've got this one on this side, the fan flywheel on that side that you can just see there, and two more in the crankcase, which form the crankshaft halves. If I can get it running, it should be very smooth. Sure what model of J.A.P it is. I thought it was a 600cc SV Mark III Type 5, but it's not. It's very different. I think it's actually a 500cc engine. So I've got to do a bit more research on it. To get the oil flow going, I had to drill a hole in the oil tank filler cap. Believe it or not, someone had sort of re-soldered the top on, but put no air hole in it. So it's a dry sump, total loss lubrication system. It drips through into the crankcase, and drips out the bottom again, really.
but it passes through the two flywheels inside the crankcase, so it has a total of four flywheels. It goes through those flywheels inside into the crankshaft and is blown into the bearing. Quite clever. And I've got some oil in the fuel as well, just to help it along. Powerful little engine.
Enough of that for one day, I think. Hopefully I'll get it running a bit nicer than that. It sounds more like a two-stroke at the moment, but I assure you it is a four-stroke. Anyway, I'll have a tinker with the carburetor. Probably give that a rebuild. And smarten the thing up. See where we go from there. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. And thanks for watching.